Cristal Lalique has always been about three themes: flora, fauna, and the female form. Very simple, yet universal. Constantly revisited and always relevant, which is what makes any Lalique piece so timeless and so essential. Rene Lalique's original inspirations came from Art Nouveau and Art Deco, yet today, Lalique is more sought after than ever. Excellence is not a luxury, it's about honesty and real values. From that comes true beauty, which is a perfect definition of Cristal Lalique.
Alsace is the home of the world's best foie gras. Now we know that some people, not you of course, get squeamish just at the mention of this word. Someone will have to convince me one day that making foie gras out of goose or duck liver is something horrendous, but butchering steak is okay. So relax, let's just enjoy the beautiful setting of this Sofitel Strasbourg award-winning restaurant and spread a little happiness. On toast, of course. There's glass, and then there is Lalique, unique Lalique, crystal glass. Every piece is different. Every piece is a brilliant fusion of artistry, craftsmanship, of poetic whimsy, and unerring skill. Rene Lalique felt this way. Once he had found glass as a perfect expression of his art, not only did he never turn back, but his creations became the bellwether standard by which every other glassmaker's work was measured. His towering creative influence is still very much alive today. So, let's go deep into the forests of the Vosges Mountains, 1 hour, just 1 hour away from here, where every piece of Lalique is still made.
This plant in Wingen-sur-Moder was built in the Vosges forest by Rene Lalique himself in 1921. He located here because there were limitless supplies of wood to heat his furnaces. Of course, Lalique switched to clean, safe propane gas a long time ago. But the plant is still here, and everything else that happens here has remained essentially unchanged. The properties of crystal are quite different from ordinary glass. Lead makes it heavier and softer. It also makes it brighter, more transparent, and more interesting to work with. Pressure-injected motifs in glowing colors or subtle opalescent blooms are all part of the split-second temperature-sensitive ballet of the molten glass craftsman, and they are mainly men. For this is pretty physical stuff, and some of those bigger pieces need three strong men to take the gather from the oven to the workbench. Now the crystal is cold, it'll be worked by hand in a dozen different ways. Grinding, etching, bead blasting, polishing, and so much more. Some quite simple pieces can be completed in a matter of hours. Most Lalique pieces take several days to make, each step mastered by caring, skilled hands. And then there are the rare, limited editions. Fine, incredibly complex and beautiful works of art where just the cooling process alone can take up to 5 weeks. In all this, at every point the work is checked. Quality control is rigorous. Any defect or flaw, however minor, is enough to discard the piece. Yet, as the process reaches its final stretch, judgment becomes subjective. Quality control becomes a matter of choice. So, a piece that may have successfully passed through every single stage of production will now be reappraised fearlessly and possibly eliminated just because. Only perfection is good enough to deserve the Lalique signature, which explains how a simple product can become a subtle, complex, sensual living treasure.